Former Philippine Vice President Lenny Robredo invited to be a visiting fellow at Harvard University. Robredo will be among the Hauser leaders of the Harvard Kennedy School's Center for Public Leadership. Robredo is expected to give lectures, lead public events, and directly engage with students and other members of the Harvard community throughout the fall semester. Robredo says she is both thrilled and humbled to be given such space to share her advocacies and experiences. The Hauser Leaders Program, now on its 8th year, invites leaders in government, in private sector, and nonprofit organizations. Robredo will be joined by four other Hauser leaders, including former U.S. Representative Jane Harman. Philippine Senator Cynthia Villar demands the resignation of heads of agricultural-related agencies due to their poor performance. That's after she learned key programs given to them are either on a snail-paced mode or are not progressing at all. Among those at the receiving end of Villar's wrath, Philippine Coconut Authority Administrator Benjamin Madrigal. At a Senate hearing Thursday, Villar called out Madrigal for failing to distribute benefits to farmers under the Coconut Farmers and Industry Trust Fund Act, more than a year after the law was approved.
Ikaw ang head ng PCA, hindi ba responsibility mo na ma-implement yan? Eh di tawagan mo ng tawagan kung ayaw nilang mag-request, ikaw ang mag-follow up. Bakit ka mag-wash ng hand dyan? Eh ikaw ang head ng PCA. Kung hindi mo kayang gawin yan, di mag-resign ka.
I will, Madam Chair.
Ang hirap sa inyo. Gusto niyo position, ayaw niyo magtrabaho.
The heads of the other agencies, such as Bureau of Soils and Water Management, and the Philippine Center for Post-Harvest Development and Mechanization also got a tongue-lashing from Senator Villar. That's as the agencies also failed to utilize funds meant to help local farmers. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel not in favor of concluding the Blue Ribbon probe on the sugar importation mess until Executive Secretary Vig Rodriguez returns to face the committee. See, Committee Chair Francis Tolentino is eyeing to wrap up the investigation soon, but Tolentino said Rodriguez may not be able to attend another hearing because of his busy schedule. Senator Pimentel finds this reason unacceptable, saying the executive secretary still has to clarify his role in the crafting of the botched sugar importation order. He believes Rodriguez could still attend through online means. Another member of the minority, Senator Risa Ontiveros, also wants Rodriguez back in the next hearing.
Kung humarap lang sa amin si ES para sagutin itong mga tanong na ipaalala ko lang sa atin, bunga ng privileged speech ng no less than aming Senate President, kaya na i-refer sa Blue Ribbon, eh baka may mga issue siyang malilay to rest.
The Philippine Customs Bureau reinstates six officials who were relieved last week over alleged sugar smuggling at the country's Subic port. Customs Chief Yogi Filimon Ruiz says a probe found no negligence on the part of the officials since the supposed smuggled sugar was found to be properly documented. The Customs Bureau earlier seized the allegedly smuggled sugar amounting to some 7,000 metric tons. An agriculture group warns local rice prices may increase next month. That's if government fails to distribute the 8 billion peso subsidy to around 1.6 million farmers in the first week of September. Some groups say the possible price increase is meant to help rice farmers cover production costs in the absence of the subsidy from government.
4 to 5 pesos yun ang nakikita natin from 38 to 43, ganon. 43 per kilo. So yun ang mangyayari kung hindi naibigay yung ayuda. Malaking effect yan sa ating consumer. So lalo na kung makita natin yung world market price ng bigas sa other countries, mataas din. Tumaas din yung presyo ng imported.
From about 1,000 pesos per bag ng urea, sumipa siya ng over 3,000 bucks, 3,000 pesos per bag. No? And normally, you would use about 4 to 6 bags of fertilizer per hectare. No? So, ang estimate namin, tumaas yung cost of production nila just from fertilizer cost ng mga 10 to 15,000 pesos per hectare. No? Wala pa din yung increase sa fuel, pati yung labor cost tumaas.
The Agriculture Department is looking into the price projection.
Yung mga ganyan pong movement ng agricultural inputs definitely affects our farm gate price. So ang tinitingnan po natin ngayon is yung palay price po, yung paggalaw nun ng ating commodity